Chapter number 28, verses 16 to 20. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I command you. And surely, I am with you always, to the very end of the age." So this was the word Jesus told his disciples just immediately after his resurrection. Because when those accusers, they crucified him, they thought they finished him, but Jesus was risen from the dead. I tell you, the enemy may bury you. The enemy may bury you, thinking you are finished, but I'm telling you, my dear brother, you're going to germinate. You're going to germinate, and you're going to revive back. You're going to bounce back from your setback. You can turn your setback, your comeback through Jesus Christ. He's going to revive you back. Jesus is going to resurrect anything that is dead in you, as he resurrected Lazarus from the dead. And Jesus himself resurrected. So this Easter, we're remembering the arresting of Jesus, crucifixion, and the resurrection, and the dead. And so he was arrested, crucified, died, and arose on the third day according to the scripture, so that the commandment and the will of God may be done, so you and me may have eternal life. Because for God so loved the world, John 3:16, that he gave Jesus as a ransom for all, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So through Jesus, he was crucified, arrested, mocked. If you read in chapter 27, you see Jesus was mocked. Chapter 27, verse 27, he was mocked. They cast lot, took his clothes, they accused him, they gave him wine. A lot of insults were done to him during the crucifixion. When you read from 32 to 44, there was somewhere they were saying, from 32 to 44, some of the verses were telling him, he was saying, "He's the King of the Jews, save yourself now." Jesus was insulted, scoffed, also scoffers, insult. He was hail abuse, they cast out his clothes, but Jesus did not say a word. So I tell you, Jesus said, if he was done all this, how about you? You're going to be done the same because of Jesus. But stand firm, Jesus said in the last verse that he's going to be with you with the very end. And we are given a great commission that we make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And Jesus is going to be with you to the very end. Trust Jesus, surrender to him, depend on his power. And he's going to bless you. He's going to raise you to higher ground. Trust in Jesus and never be ashamed. If you have not believed in Jesus, the Bible says, if you confess, Romans 10:9, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that he rose on the he rose from the dead, you'll be saved. And if you confess, you'll be saved. And God loves you, love all people. He demonstrates his love by this. What we are saying here, Jesus was crucified, arrested, died, and rose for you and me that we may have life. Because our good work, our good life, our life on earth can be acceptable before God through Jesus Christ. And that is the whole duty of God to us, that we obey God. So we're going to sing Easter song of saying Jesus was crucified for us, saying that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. As we wish one another a good Easter, as we celebrate our Messiah, is the principal reason why we are.
Way. It's the only way to go. Surrender to me.
Yes, surrender to me.